Hello friends, here we are going to see a chapter called as Projections of Solids in the subject Engineering Drawing. Let us get started. In this video, I describe how many types of solids are there and how we are going to project them. That we are going to see in this video. Projections of solids. In this, basically we need to know how many kinds of solids are there. Like for example, cylinder is considered as a solid. Then there is cone, cube, pyramid, prism. Tetrahedron and etc. These are the kinds of solids. When we talk about cylinder, it looks like this, having a circle at the top and even at the bottom and having a height. This is a cylinder. Then there is a cone. Which is having a circular base and an apex. Which is, I'll say 0.0. Next, there is cube. Which is having all its dimensions as equal, that is length, width and height are equal in case of cube. Next, pyramid. Pyramids are of different shapes and they are defined based upon their number of edges of the base. Like there may be square pyramid having four edges at the base. Then there will be pentagonal pyramid having five base edges. Then hexagonal pyramid having six base edges. And after that there is even octagonal pyramid having eight base edges. So a pyramid is defined based on the shape of its base. Like for example, here I have drawn the diagram of a square pyramid in which we have four base edges and it is forming a square. Next, all the base edges are connected to a point or a vertex which is point O. So this is a square pyramid. Similarly, we can have pentagonal pyramid which has five base edges, hexagonal pyramid which has six base edges. Then there is prism. Prism, like I can consider cylinder which is having at top a circle and even at the bottom there is a circle. So cylinder can also be considered as a circular prism. Next, cube can also be considered as a prism. It means prism is that solid in which the base as well as the top, they are same. It means if at the base, like for example, if I draw a hexagonal prism, hexagonal prism has hexagon means six sides at the top and even six sides at the bottom. And prisms, they have all their faces as rectangles. It means whatever is the shape of the top and the base, the faces of the prism are in the form of rectangle. Like in case of pyramid, the base edges may be of any given shape. It may be square, it may be hexagon or pentagon, but the sides are triangular faces. In case of pyramid, we have triangular faces. In case of prism, we have rectangular faces. So this is the basic difference between a prism and a pyramid. In case of pyramid, the base edge or the shape of the base defines the pyramid, and at the top it is connected to a common vertex or a point, or we can say a corner. Whereas in case of prism, the base edges define the shape. That is, here it is a hexagonal prism, and hexagon is there at the top and bottom, whereas all the sides, they are having rectangular faces. Next, there is tetrahedron, which is like a triangular pyramid. Tetrahedron is that solid in which all the faces are triangular as well as the base is triangular. It means we keep tetrahedron anyhow, we are going to get the same shape. The same is not possible for some of the solids, like for example pyramid. If we are not keeping it on the square edge, if we tilt it onto the triangular face, then the orientation changes. But in case of tetrahedron, since all the faces, even the base, is in the form of a triangle, even though we place it anyhow, we are going to get the same shape. So that is a tetrahedron. Next, in case of solids, as I have defined the vertexes for cone and for prism, in case of the other solids, we have these edges, or they are also called as sides. Like even in case of prism, here we have edges or sides. If the prism is of hexagon shape, it will have 6 edges, then it will have 6 rectangular faces. If there is square prism, then it will have 4 base edges, 4 sides, and we can say 4 rectangular faces. So in short, here I have described how many kinds of solids are there. When we are talking about projection of solids, in that case we would be tilting these solids. That is, the solids would be given to us in the initial condition, like they are resting. Then we have to tilt them at a certain angle. Now that angle will be about an axis. If we are having a solid, like for example a cylinder, here is the axis of the cylinder, which is the axis of symmetry, which divides it into two equal parts. So either we can tilt any of the solid about its axis, like there is cone, there is cylinder, we can tilt them about their axis, or we can tilt them about their base edges. Even in case of pyramids, here I can draw the axis. Even in case of prism, so here we can say that either the solid will be tilted about its axis, or it can be tilted about its base edge, or any of the given conditions. It means the solid will not be stable like this. In the initial condition, the solid will be resting. After that, depending on the question, we have to make it inclined. And when it is inclined, how it will look like from the front view and from the top view, that we are going to draw in case of projection of solids. First, we are going to start with two stage problems in which there would only be two conditions, and finally we are going on to three stage problems in which there will be three conditions. So in short, this was an explanation regarding the introduction of projection of solids.